Thousands at the Pearl Harbor shipyard now face furloughs. Manolo Morales joins us with more. Manolo?
Joe, more than 3,000 shipyard workers at Pearl Harbor will be furloughed as a result of the budget impasse of Congress. Some will be kept on the job, but they won't be paid until the budget is approved. For workers at the Pearl Harbor Naval Shipyard, there were many questions leading up to this day.
How are you going to pay your bills? How are you going to feed your family? Pretty sure everybody's thinking like that. That's pretty much it.
Their union, the Hawaii Metal Trades Council, says there are a total of 4,500 workers in the shipyard. 1,200 will be exempt from the furloughs.
To protect national security, life and property and safety. So it leaves about a balance of about over 3,000 employees that will be furloughed.
But they won't get paid until the Congress standoff is over and a budget is approved. Workers can only hope that the stalemate doesn't last more than a couple of days.
But the longer it goes, I'm pretty sure it'd be pretty bad, yeah. Because, you know, only one income in the household, yeah, going. So I've got a couple of kids, so it'd be pretty tough.
There are many others in the same ship. There are about 9,000 federal workers employed by the U.S. Navy who face the same fate. Their union representative says they've already had to deal with so many cuts.
You know, Congress is acting irrationally and irresponsibly right now, and it's the federal workers that are going to be suffering for it. And we've already been suffering through sequestration, like I said, with the furloughs and the reductions in force and the, you know, pay freezes.
So there's frustration aimed towards Capitol Hill.
We can't do nothing but roll with it and do the best we can and just deal with it, I guess, right? I mean, that's how we're going to do it, but it just sucks that we were on the end of it, yeah.
The unions will be asking for retroactive pay for the furloughed workers, but that also has to be approved by Congress. Manolo Morales, KHON 2 News.